What if you could automate highly complex, specialized knowledge tasks and delegate them to anybody so that you could share it out and have anyone run them? Let's check out how Calm does that today. Hello, and welcome to another episode in our Calm series of tech topics where we step through all of the different components. My name is Chris Brown, and today we're going to be talking about creating custom actions, running actions, and then auditing that. Now in Calm, an action is any sort of task or operation that you do every week, every day, every month, whatever it may be, and turn it into push-button automation. Take something that might touch multiple different apps with multiple different skill sets or multiple different tiers of an app, and turn it into a one-click operation that you can then delegate and let anyone control, while at the same time auditing it so you understand who ran it, when, and what the output was. Today we're going to talk about how to create custom actions, how do you run your actions, and then how to audit it so you can see the logging and understand what happened in your environment and why. Let's get started. Here we have a complex application. We've got our databases, web servers, load balancers, and a Redis cache. Calm by default creates some actions such as create, start, stop, and delete. We can also add our own custom actions by clicking the little plus sign here. Now we have the ability to add in particular tasks for each service in this application. For example, on the load balancer, I could add a task. Like everything else, this can be any shell script, any PowerShell script or API call, and eventually config management integration as well. Maybe this is something as basic as log activity. And I just want this to echo the now, whenever anyone who has access to the blueprint wants to, they can immediately capture and log and store the information from the load balancers. We can also create very complex actions that touch upon multiple tiers in this service. So let's clear out this task. Maybe I want to do an upgrade task. The first thing in my upgrade is that I need to update the DB schema. I won't fill out all the scripts here, just for simplicity's sake. After that, I need to flush the Redis cache, then update the app code, and then finally, I need to update the load balancer config. So once I've created these actions, I now just need to wire them up together in the order I want them to run. So I click on the first task, then the little arrow, and then to what should run right after this. And I repeat. I can even do multiple actions after one, or multiple dependencies for a particular action. I can even have multiple tasks within each action and have them orchestrate back and forth. Maybe this is my application verification step, and then I need to go back and commit some logs on the app servers after doing the upgrade. Calm will now enforce this action throughout, and you can publish it to your end users. So based on their role within the project, they can call it as well, doing these complex multiple-tier operations across many different components. To run an action against a running application, the first thing you need to do is go to the Applications view, which is the third button down. Next, click on the application you want to run it against. Then you can click on Manage. This shows you all the actions that have been created for this particular application and the blueprint behind it. You can click on the little eye on any of the actions to get a better idea of what this action is going to do. You'll also see on the right the output from the last time this action was ran. To run any of these actions, simply click the little play sign next to the action and confirm. You can now see the logs as they roll in on the right-hand side here. Calm is capturing all the logs from every action called against your applications, no matter what infrastructure or cloud it's running on, be it AHV, AWS, or an existing machine. In order to get access to those logs, you need to go in, go to the Applications view, click on the application you want to view the logs for, and then click on Audit. You can now see all of the actions that were called against this machine, when they were ran, and if you click on one, you can get more information about this, such as who ran it and what the logging output was. If we go down here to the Create action, for example, and click on the provision Nutanix, we can see the exact API call that we made against Nutanix and what the response was. We can also see the output from particular scripts. For example, if we go down here to the package install task, we can see the exact output from this. We can also click this little button over here to pop it out to increase the size of the window. You can also download the logs from a particular task or from an entire action using the buttons here next to the tasks. This can be used to export it to another tool or to analyze it offline or to archive. So that's actions. Actions are incredibly powerful, and really the sky's the limit. One of the things that I always ask myself is there a way a computer could have done this? Is there any task that you do that takes some time or is just a little, a little painful to do that you can automate, that you can turn into push-button operations? Things like making a new VDI desktop and attaching a user to it, or adding a table to a database, or doing an upgrade of a whole application. Is there any way that I can make a computer do this and make my life easier? Make sure to subscribe to our channel so you can catch the other updates in this series, and keep an eye out because we'll be continuously releasing new updates to Tech Topics anytime Calm gets new features. Thank you so much for joining us today. Have a great day.